Hey guys, welcome back to another video. Thank you so much for being here. For those of you who made it back to another video, I truly appreciate you. On today's video, I am gonna be doing an unboxing. Sephora just had their spring sale and I bought some things and I figured I would share them with you. I also got some stuff at the Pat McGrath website because I love her mascara and I ended up buying some things and I just kind of wanted to share those things with you, unbox them with you. Now, before we get started, if you haven't already done so, don't forget to subscribe to the Dallas Does Makeup family. If you haven't already, go ahead and subscribe to my channel so you don't miss a beat. Put on your notifications, right? So I'll be doing weekly videos. This week I'm posting an extra video just because I had a little extra time, but I'll be posting weekly videos until further notice. So join me. Now, if you like this video, don't forget to like it, comment, and let me know what you want to see in another video. I'm still trying to figure out what I want to put out there for you all and when. So just let me know. What do you want to see? What do you want to see next? All right. Today is actually Sunday. The sale actually started on the 1st and I thought my package was going to get here earlier. I planned to record this video last week, but it took a few days for the package to get here. So I'm just now opening this up. Here it is. Sephora. All right. And let's see. Let's make sure everything is in here. All right. So this is the spring savings event, and it actually lasts for one more day. So, like I said, I was actually hoping this would come earlier. I actually ordered this on the 1st. And that's one thing that is kind of annoying. When you order during the sale, you actually have to be prepared to wait a little bit longer because everything takes a little bit longer unless you're getting it in the store. I didn't go to the store. But all right, let's see. I think everything is in here. So wait a minute. Ugh, is this the same one? No. Ugh. This is the same one. Ugh. I'm so upset. I keep getting the same one. Anyways, whatever. Okay. So all right, let's get started. So the first thing I got is I restocked on my Drunk Elephant Proteiny Polypeptide Cream. And I really, really love this moisturizer. It says it has 9 signal peptides and it has a pH of 4.0. Okay. All right, so let me go ahead and read the description for you all. I don't have my glasses on and I'm not going to put them on because I don't want you to see the glare, but I'm going to read through. So if it sounds like I can't read, it's not because I can't read. It's because I can't see. This breakthrough protein moisturizer combines an unprecedented array and concentration of signal peptides, growth factors, supportive amino acids, and pygmy water lily for immediate improvement in the appearance of skin's tone, texture, and firmness. Proteiny's proprietary formula restores younger, revived-looking skin almost from the first application. Lines, wrinkles, and signs of sun damage appear reduced and skin feels strengthened and moisturized. I don't know what any of that means, but I will say this. I do agree with the part that says that the skin feels instantly moisturized. Another thing that I really like about this product is that it doesn't have a lot of fragrance, so if you don't like too much fragrance in your creams, you can use this. All right, so I restocked on that. All right, the next thing I got is the, so I got a mixture of skincare and makeup products. So the next thing I got, which, why is it in this plastic bag? Why? Anyway, so this is the Makeup Forever color pencil. You can actually use these as whatever eyeliner or lip liner. I actually got it to replace my NARS pencil. If you all have watched my other videos, I really did like the formula for the NARS pencil, except that it broke. The pencil, when you sharpen it, it breaks. And the actual color, the pencil color, actually comes out of the frame, the pencil frame, which is really annoying. So I saw this color, which was similar, and I figured, hey, let me try this one, right? So, yeah, so let me see if I can. These freaking nails. I can't do anything with long nails anymore. I really just am so ready to take these off. Wow. 3 hours later. Let me see what this color looks like. It's a little bit whiter than I wanted it to be. But I can work with that, I guess. Let me compare it to the NARS. I actually like the NARS one better. This is the NARS one. And as you can see, the actual product falls out, which I absolutely hate. I just pull it out and apply it like that, but it broke. Yeah. So, yeah, it's way lighter. Oh, it's breaking. So this is the NARS one, and this is the Makeup Forever one. Don't know how I feel about that. I'll just keep that in my bag. Ugh. Yeah, I'm just gonna have to buy another NARS one eventually, because I really do love this color. It's just like perfect on my eye. It brightens just enough because I have more of like that olive complexion, so it just works for my eye, my under eye. Let me try it out really quickly, see how I like it. It doesn't look so bad. It's not so bad. It's just a little bit whiter than I want it, which is fine. Oh, my eye. All right, so next, I got the Lancome Drama 24-Hour Drama Liquid Pencil. And I was looking for something brown that could replace my brown eyeliner. I wanted something rich and brown. And this looks pretty, this looks really nice. Yeah, this looks really nice. I'm not gonna try this now. I'll try this on another video. But it looks really pretty. I think it's gonna serve its purpose. I wanted it to be a little bit darker, honestly. I was trying to replace it with the MAC brown that they have. It was like a, I forget the, it's like a coffee color. And they discontinued it. They discontinue all of the good stuff. This one thing about MAC that annoys me. It's like they have really great colors and then they just discontinue them. All right. This is the little sample they give you in the box that you can select. I chose this, the hair oil by Way, and this replica scent. It's called Autumn Vibes. I don't think this is the one I chose, but whatever. I'll go with it. Let's just smell it. You know I get migraines, so over scents. So let's see. Maybe I shouldn't spray it on me, because then if I get it on me, then I'll die. It smells like a man. Yeah. It smells like a man. This smells more like a room spray. I wouldn't wear this at all. I do like how it develops. I kind of like how it develops. You can smell like the first surface scent first, and then once it settles into the napkin, it kind of develops into more of a woodsy. And it says Autumn Vibes, fragrance description. Yeah, woody, trail, and red leaves. Memory and a fragrance. I wouldn't wear this. For me, this is more of like a masculine scent, which I don't know. Like, let's see. Is this a, it's like a masculine scent or like a room scent? It's really interesting. It's pretty strong too. Yeah, this is definitely not for me. Maison Margiela. France. All right, yeah. I mean, it smells good, but I just wouldn't wear it. Yeah, it's too strong for me. And then I thought I got the Versace. And I don't know why I keep thinking the Dylan Blue is the girl version. I really have been wanting to get the mini version of the girl scent, the Versace Blue. And I keep getting this one. And this is also a male scent. I don't have a man. If not, I would give these to him. So, yeah, this is a male scent too. I'll probably give it to one of my brothers or something. Okay. So. Next. And I think finally, because I didn't buy that much. You girls on a budget. It was a restock. All right. So I'm really excited about this because I actually tried this bottle, this product before. It's the Belief or Belief. Oh, Believe in Truth. So I think it is Belief. But it's not spelled correctly. So I'm not 100% sure. But anyway, so you all know, if you know me, you know I love sets. And you know I like to try things in sets before I buy them full size. So I actually bought this set. It was different though. It was a moisturizing set and it came with the toner, which I ran out of. I'm okay. The toner is fine. I don't know if it's like my favorite, but it's nice. And so I really fell in love with this brand's eye moisturizer. It's the Moisturizing Eye Balm. And I really love how soft it is on under the eye. I've used other brands and, you know, I really do like the Drunk Elephant one too. And the Biosense one is really nice. But I tried this one. I really liked how moisturizing and light it was under my eye. And this particular set actually brings the sample sizes of the toner and the moisturizing balm, which is also really nice. It's really, really nice. But this is more so of a small set. Yeah, this scent, this fragrance is too strong. I don't like it anymore. It's starting to give me a headache, so I'm gonna throw this out. Ooh. Oh my God. Putting alcohol on this to drown out the smell. Ugh. It's too strong for me. Oh, let me smell some of this coffee. Okay, I think I feel better now.
I'm feeling much better now.
All right, so, and it also brings a small sample size of their jelly cleanser, which I've never tried. So now I get to try a new product, right? So I have all those things, and that's what I bought. And on the sale, you have different tiers for you to get a discount. So you can either get, I think it's like 20, 15, and 10, if I'm not mistaken, but it goes by your level. So if you're just like a regular customer, you can actually get like the lowest level. And then if you're VIB, then you get like 15%. And then if you're Rouge, you get like 20%, which, you know, your girl's Rouge because I spent a lot of money there. So I get the extra, percentage. And I hate to say that I spent a lot of money there, guys. I don't spend that much money there, but I spend enough to be Rouge. And I love Sephora, so I buy a lot of my stuff there. But anyways, so that's so far what I bought at Sephora. And now I'm going to unbox the Pat McGrath box. Okay. Let me make sure to check my receipt, my invoice. My goodness. They use a lot of paper, these places. All right. So I ended up getting the Pat McGrath mascara, which is my favorite mascara. It's the best on the market, in my opinion. I love this mascara so, so much. And I ran out. I found out I loved it when I got the mini. I ended up getting the mini, and it was like my favorite. But I actually already have mascara on, so it might not look different, but I just love how this really goes on. You can't really tell the difference, but I just love how that applies on my eyelids. So this is the Dark Star mascara. You can't really see it because I already had some on there. And the next thing I bought was the, because I have the Pat McGrath Labs Permagel Ultra Glide Eye Pencil, and I really love this because once you put it on, it really doesn't go anywhere. It's not as malleable as the other liners I like to use when I'm blending, but it's a great eyeliner to use when you want to really add depth to your eye. Now, I decided to order the Pat McGrath Perma Precision Liquid Eyeliner because, as you probably remember, my eyeliner, when I took it to Las Vegas, it actually, I don't know what happens. I think it's just like the air pressure. Every time I take the eyeliner somewhere I travel with it, it explodes. And now I've continued to use it, but I have to be very careful because there's like a part on the eyeliner that's like exploded. And I do have some left over of the Rihanna Flyliner, but the Flyliner is not my favorite. I feel like it's really black, but I feel like the tip is just too long. I like a shorter tip on my eyeliner. So I like to use that one to really just like shadow in, but I don't really like drawing my eyeliner with it. So my wing eye with it. But I bought this one. And let me see how it is. Okay. Let me see how I'm going to open this. Oh, here are my scissors. These are my lash scissors. I shouldn't be cutting this, but whatever. All right. So, see. Oh, this is kind of like the same one. This looks like a little bit more, I don't know, let's see. I'm gonna have to play with this. So it looks a lot like the Fenty. I want to say the Fenty actually looks a little bit more richer in color. And it could be the undertones in it. I would say that this one's a little bit more gray. A little bit. Yeah, I would say that the Fenty is a little bit blacker than this one. And again, this is probably the undertone. This one has more of like a green undertone, and this one has more of like a blue, I guess, undertone. If I were to put it under a microscope, I'm half blind, but that's what I see. They're both beautiful. It's just the tip, the felt tip. And the reason why, it's just like these get so, sometimes they get a little weird on the ends. When they start drying up, the end starts drying up. So, like, the Fenty end starts drying up, and it doesn't have the same, like, it's hard to explain. I'm going to just have to work with it. But yeah, I kind of like the Fenty's, how black the Fenty one is. Huh, that's weird. So when I tried the Fenty mascara versus the Pat McGrath, I actually liked the Pat McGrath mascara more. And now it seems like I like the Fenty eyeliner more. Interesting. We'll see. I'm gonna play with this and see how I like it. But all right, and one more thing I'm excited to share with you all. All right, this is the last product I'm going to share. This is the Mothership Rose Decadence palette. And I will say, Pat McGrath's palettes are pretty pricey. And I'm really interested in seeing if they are worth the hype. Now, the colors look pretty. They look really pretty, actually. Oh, that's really nice. Interesting. So this is one of their, I wouldn't say they're pricier palettes. This is one of like the medium kind of medium grade shadow palettes. And so far it looks nice. I will say the colors are pretty unique. I think one thing about eyeshadow palettes is like you'll buy a palette and it kind of looks like other colors. I like the undertones on these. They're kind of, it's nice. I like it. That's really pretty. I really, really like that. All right, so I'm doing a terrible job swatching these, but so far I really like the colors. So I like the undertones on the colors. I feel like on the surface they look pretty common, but when you swatch them, they have some really pretty undertones. And my hand is a hot mess, but so far I've swatched the color. Let me see, the colors are Pink Champagne, which is this top one here. Hedonistic Rose, which is this one right here. You got Peach Dusk, Scandalous, which is right here. Fuchsia Flame, and Golden Honey. So all of those are in this palette, and yeah, they're really nice. I like the, like I said, I like the undertones on them. So I'm gonna definitely do a look with these and I will be back with more. These are gorgeous. These are really, really pretty. So far I really like this palette. And I think this is one of the cheaper palettes. I know she has some more expensive palettes, but this is more of like the mid-grade palette that she has. And I'm really excited to try it out, and I'll try it with her eyeliner and do a look, an entire look. But anyway, tell me what you think. What did you think of the unboxing? Did you all get anything from the Sephora sale? And yeah, what are your favorite products and which ones do you think I should try for the next order I have? All right. Well, anyways, thank you all so much for joining me for another video. I hope you liked this video. If you did, go ahead and like it. Go ahead and comment. And don't forget to subscribe. Join me for some nonsense and some girl talk. But if you all have any questions or want to see anything, leave it in the comments, and I hope to see you in the next video. Bye.